Welcome back. Congrats. I want to hear all about Dr. Death.
But, of course.
But before we get to that, I have a... First of all, since the last time you were here, you had another beautiful baby boy.
Yes, congratulations. I did. Thank you.
Always love hearing that.
I was pregnant last time I was here, but I wasn't telling anybody. So technically, Ozzy has been on the show.
On the Tonight Show. Hi, yeah. Ozzy, again, if you're watching. Yeah, I'll watch the repeats, Ozzy, that's a beautiful
one. Yeah, so Gus, our older guy, he's the only one that hasn't been on. Because last time, my husband Taylor played with me when I played some music, so.
Oh, that's right.
We got to get Gus on here,
How old is Gus now,
Gus
3?
Gus is almost 3, yeah.
Yeah. And Ozzy's a great name. Where did it come from, Ozzy?
We like the name Oscar and just like the name Ozzy. Not Ozzy Osbourne, but just O-Z-Z-I-E.
Yeah, Ozzy Osbourne's great, too.
Sabbath, obviously.
Yeah, obviously, yeah, of course.
But, we liked both of those names. So he can sort of pick as
baby.
He gets older. Yeah, he's a year now.
Yeah, okay, yeah. So are you getting all... Christmas, is that a big deal at the house?
Yeah,
or
I feel like Gus is just starting to sort of understand what Christmas and Santa and presents and being patient, like all of that is.
Yeah, and do you go crazy with decorations and do you have traditions? Do you have Elf on the Shelf?
I think he's a little too young for that.
Yeah,
I'm pacing myself.
Yeah.
But we have, we just moved, so we're starting to sort of figure out what our roots are and cementing, like, what our traditions are going to be. But growing up, my parents claimed their first year of marriage they didn't have any food in the house on Christmas Eve other than breakfast food. Mm. So we... That was our tradition growing up as kids. We had breakfast for dinner on Christmas Eve.
I kind of like this idea.
So I feel like I'm going to incorporate that for us.
So what would you have like a...
Pancakes, waffles, bagels, eggs, bacon, like the whole nine yards.
I love this.
Yeah, it was so much fun.
Oh, I might take this from you.
Go for it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm taking people's traditions this year. That's my new thing.
Me too. Just trying to steal everything.
Yeah, Gwen Stefani gave me one tradition once. She said she wraps the doorway into the living room so that when the kids see Christmas morning, they run through the paper.
Wow.
Yeah.
Like football players running through the banner.
Exactly correct. You need to have a point person on the other side because it gets disastrous. They're tackling the tree. They're like, and like, okay, this is disaster. I don't keep that tradition up.
I'm not sure I'll borrow that one from you.
No, yeah. But you're musical, obviously. Your husband's very musical.
Sure.
Are the kids musical?
I mean, so much as we can tell at this point, sure. My husband has incredible taste in music, and he's curated great playlists for the boys. So Gus, our older guy, will ask for, like, Warren Zevon, Werewolves of London, over, like, we don't have to listen to Baby Shark in our house.
Really?
Which is, like, such a win. Yeah.
Wow.
Or he's like, I want to hear Tom Petty, Refugee. I'm like, absolutely, sir.
Wow.
Whatever you want. Yeah, he's got good taste.
He's a cool 3-year-old. Gus, I want to hear Gus's playlist. I have a picture here that I thought made me laugh. This is you and Gus posing with Rapunzel.
Yes.
And from Tangled.
Yes.
Now, you actually are the voice of Rapunzel.
I am the voice of Rapunzel.
Does Rapunzel know that you're the voice of Rapunzel?
I believe so, but they are so solidly in character, they're not allowed to break character, that there was, like, not a wink. There was...
No, you're right.
There was no acknowledgement.
They're pros,
by the
way.
Oh, they're super pros.
They can't break at all, even for a little bit. You go, you can tell me.
No. And absolutely not. But Gus, by the way, he couldn't have cared less. He's like, you're not Lightning McQueen. There's no cars situation.
He's not impressive.
No.
Mom is the voice of Rapunzel?
I've asked him several times. I'm like, do you want to, you've seen Frozen now. Do you want to watch Tangled? He's like, no. Not, no.
No interest at all.
No.
Did you have to leave voice memos for parents and stuff? Because we have a lot of people on the show.
Oh, for sure. As when the movie came out, like, oh my gosh, over 10 years ago, I left a lot of voicemails for children, like parents imploring me, like, can you tell my daughter that Rapunzel loves to brush her teeth?
Yeah.
Always brushes her teeth every night before she goes to bed. So I left a lot of those helping parents
out.
Yeah,
good for you to do that. That's awesome. I do want to talk about, obviously, you know, I loved you on This Is Us.
Thank you.
And then you got this opportunity to do this role in Dr. Death.
Yeah.
Did you go like, oh, this is a different role for me. I like this.
Yeah, it was a bit of a left turn. I had a 6-week-old baby, and this opportunity came about, and to be here in New York, and it's based on a true story. It was just something I couldn't say no to. It's an anthology series. I basically play an investigative reporter who is doing the story on this famous Italian surgeon who is pioneering regenerative medicine, and he's growing tracheas in his lab and implanting them in people, and I cross the ethical boundaries as a journalist and fall in love with him, and It's a wild true story.
I mean, it is a real true story.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes.
And yeah, this is all based on this
a podcast.
Podcast. Yeah. Which is fantastic. But this is great, and you don't have to know anything about season one to love season
it's
two.
It's an anthology. Yeah, whole new story, whole new doctor. Yeah.
Oh, congratulations! I want to show everyone a clip. Here's Mandy Moore in the new season of Dr. Death. Take a look.
So, who is our benefactor this evening?
I shouldn't say.
Paulo, come on. I protect sources for a living.
He's a Russian oligarch, very connected. But oh, look. There is a network of high-profile patients, celebrities, clergy, presidents that are treated in secret, that I treat in secret. Because of who they are, I have to keep our enrichment quiet.
Presidents, like U.S. presidents? Paolo Macchiarini, surgeon to the stars? Somebody's got to do it, right?
Come on. Mandy Moore, everybody. All 8 episodes of Dr. Death Season 2 will be available on Peacock this Thursday. Elvis Duran joins us after the break. Stick around, everybody.